There is a very common question that we face in Oracle interviews. What is the difference between a procedure and a function? I've seen in the past people giving these usual answers. You cannot perform a DML statement inside a function, which can be done in a procedure. You cannot have out parameters in a function. A function can only return a single value. These statements don't highlight the actual difference between function and procedure. And most importantly, none of them are correct. Let's evaluate a couple of these statements real quick in our SQL developer. Before I do that, I have a small request. If you have not subscribed to my channel already, please do it now and don't forget to switch on the notifications. So here I have created a sales table that has random quantities between 1 to 10. Now I am creating a function that will update this sales quantity in the sales table. The common misconception is that you are not allowed to execute any DML statement inside a function. We will see how that is not true. Even though I have an update statement inside the function, it was successfully compiled. Let's verify the sales quantity real quick before we update it. Now I'm going to execute the function. The function has been executed successfully, and post this, since I have passed 4 as the quantity, all my quantity should be updated to 8. And you see that is the case. So with this, we can conclude that you can have DML statements inside functions as well. The second common answer people have is around out parameters, that how we can have them in procedures and not in functions. Well, here I'm creating a function with out parameters and I will assign the out parameter a value 1. I will compile the function real quick. To verify that the function is working as expected, I will set the server output as on. Now I have written an anonymous PLSQL block where I will display both the output and the return value. On execution, both are displayed correctly. So that indicates that we can have out parameters in functions as well. Similarly, we can return multiple values from a single function using type. But just because we can, that does not mean we should have them. When explaining the difference between a procedure and a function, you should focus on the context in which they are used. For example, function takes a set of inputs and derives something based on that. The word on which we should focus here is derive. Let's understand this a little more. For example, I can calculate my age provided I have the date of birth. So I can write a function that will return age if you provide date of birth as input. Similarly, I can write another function which returns the reduced price of products in case if a coupon is applied. So here the input parameter is the coupon code and the function is returning the reduced price of the products. The important thing to note here is that when the function is applied in the right context, it will not alter the state of any object. It will simply take a set of values as inputs, perform some computations or calculations on them, and then return the corresponding result. They are pretty similar to the functions we have in mathematics. Take some values, compute their sum, average, mean, and stuff. We should not use functions to delete, insert, or update any rows in a table. That is not what they are made for. While explaining functions, you need to focus on two keywords, derive and alter. They derive something based on input values and they do not alter the state of any object. While functions takes a set of inputs and derives something based on that, procedure does something based on the inputs. The keyword in focus here is does. Procedure basically execute program statements or business logic. And let's understand this in detail with this example. So we have written a procedure that performs the following operations when an order is about to be placed on the website. As soon as the order is received for the laptop, the procedure verifies whether the item is available in the stock or inventory. This is done by querying the stock table And if the count is greater than 1, that means the item is available in the inventory. So here we are executing some DML statements according to the business logic, first of which is the select statement. If the item was available, we will place the order and reduce the item quantity in the stock table by 1. Notice the update statement we will have to execute in order to update the quantity. Also, an entry will be inserted in the sales table for the laptop we just sold. And the procedure will not just end here. We will query and assess if the laptop quantity is below a certain threshold. If that is the case, we will initiate a restocking of the product. Another insert into the stocking table. Finally, we will insert a row each into the packing and the delivery table so that the corresponding teams get a notification that they need to package and ship the order. So you see, the entire functioning of this business logic is accomplished through the stored procedure we just wrote. And in our stored procedure, we did alter the states of multiple objects. So if you have to explain the difference to someone in one liner, you can specify that functions are normally used for computations while procedures usually execute business logic. I hope this video clarifies all your doubts regarding the difference between a procedure and a function. If you still have any doubt, just post them in the comment section and I will be replying as soon as possible. Thanks a lot guys for watching this video and I'll see you in the next one.